So I just went to go see Deepwater Horizon, and I thought it was pretty good. Initially, I didn't really want to see the film because the trailer looked pretty cheesy to me. And that is what the film was, but at the same time, it was a very compelling, touching story about a real-life event. And I'm really glad I went to go see it because I learned a lot about something I didn't know. This film is something, a part of, I guess, a sort of period for the director. He's directed The Lone Survivor and a new film coming out soon called Patriot's Day, all chronicling events of extremely tumultuous circumstances where people are really pushed to their limits. And I find that a very interesting place to be. However, what I really wanted to talk about today was how I thought this film was good, but I didn't really think it was great. Now, I couldn't help but keep relating it to this film, even though I really shouldn't have. There Will Be Blood by Paul Thomas Anderson, a really great picture about a man named Daniel who goes in the search of riches, and he does so through oil mining. Now, that film is critically acclaimed, beloved, has some great performances as well, same as this film. However, there's just this sort of line of artistic expressionism that I find in the poise of, I guess, the camera work, the use of music, and more the story itself, the way it likes to present itself. Now, the reason I wanted to bring this up is because Deepwater Horizon is based on a true story, and when making something based on a true story, usually you want to respect the events. However, I don't feel that you have to respect the events and make a film that isn't wonderful at the same time. I think both of those things can be accomplished. A recent film that I very much enjoyed was the Steve Jobs film, which really upped the expressionism, you know, just as artistic to me, or even more so Aaron Sorkin's other piece, The Social Network. A really great picture, however one could debate how accurate they were. So, in that regard, you know, one really has to ask themselves, when making a compelling narrative, when trying to convince people of something, when trying to tell a great story, do you want to tell a great story and just get that to people? Or do you want to make something that transcends the story itself? You know, a little bit of falsification is sometimes necessary to make a story more adept at being told in the way it was initially seen. I know, for example, you know, in my lifetime, I've been attacked or fought by people in school. And when seeing that in film in the same way that I saw it, it really just looked silly. But when directed, you know, like an old Asian kung fu cinema movie, it felt more like how it was. And I think that presents reality. Film, to me, I think, is just the presentation of reality. It's the way we put moving parts together to compel a narrative. So to that regard, you know, one has to ask himself, is that perhaps why great cinema is great? Is that why films like The Godfather or There Will Be Blood are so great? Because they act upon a certain inherent falsification as well as reality in between us. Deepwater Horizon is a very good film, but I don't think it's a great film. Very average, but above the average mark of what it normally should be. I want to see more films like this. I enjoyed it very much, and I would go see another film like it in theaters. I don't know if I want to see Peter Weir's Boston Bomber one. That's a little bit too kind of silly to me, just because of the events that happened. You know, were very tragic, but it's just, it, you know, how would that be a compelling narrative? But then again, I think that's why I think I might want to see it. I really like it when directors try new things, do things kind of strange, and you honestly just gotta respect it when they're not being Hollywood as fuck. Deepwater Horizon gets a 5.7 from me. I thought it was great. You should go see it if you get the chance. Buy it on Blu-ray, and I hope you have a great day.